Have you always woken up and read His Word and been in reverent prayer and thanked Him for your life and everything that He gave to you? The second commandment is that you should not have any idols. Do you have any idols? Do you watch TV too much or run too much or play too many sports? Is that what you worship? Ask yourself these questions. The third one is you should not take the Lord your God's name in vain. And I said, your God's name in vain. He's the one who gave you life. And then you take His name and use it as a filthy cuss word. He's running through the sewer. And it's just a saying. We're desensitized to this. Down here at the convention center, they have an usher sign that says the OMG tour. What do you think that means? The fourth commandment is to keep the Sabbath holy. The Lord your God has given you 7 days. And all He requires of you is to give one back in prayer, in thankfulness, in adoration. The fifth commandment is honor your mother and father. Have you always honored your mother and father? Have you always done what they said, regardless if they deserve it or not, if they're good enough or not? Have you done that? The sixth commandment is do not kill. Have you killed? Have you hated somebody in your heart? The Lord Jesus Christ says, if you hate somebody in your heart, you are a murderer. The seventh commandment is do not commit adultery. Have you committed adultery? Have you looked at a woman with lust? Jesus Christ said, whoever looks upon a person with lust has committed adultery already in their heart. Have you committed adultery? The eighth commandment is do not steal. Have you ever punched in a work and stood around and did nothing? Have you ever gone on a smoke break for a half an hour and done nothing? Have you taken something from somebody, regardless of the value? And even if you gave it back, if I were to go over here to this business and take something out of there and even took it back because I felt bad about it, I'm still going to prison. They're still going to come out and put the cuffs on me and take me away because I stole it. The ninth commandment is do not lie. How many people can say they haven't lied? Or told a half-truth? Or exaggerated? I lied, and I'm a liar. The tenth commandment is, do not covet. Have you ever wanted something that somebody else has? Have you ever been caught up in gambling that you wanted more money? Have you ever done that? Have you coveted? Have you wanted your neighbor's wife or his belongings? The way the Lord is going to see us on judgment day is that we've all lied. We've all stolen. We've all looked for clothes. We've all taken His name in vain. So standing in front of Him, in front of judgment, we're going to be lying, thieving, blaspheming, with all of His heart. We're going to have to face Him on judgment day. Because the Lord is holy, and perfect, and good. He's going to judge us righteously. Riches profit not on the day of wrath, but righteousness delivers from death.
Yeah.
We're going to be guilty of this. And when we're guilty, we will be condemned to hell. The hell is a place of outer darkness, where the Word never dies. The lake of fire. And this is a promise through the Holy Word of God, through the Scripture. The only way to be away from that is that we need to repent and put our faith in Christ. God came down from heaven, wrapped in flesh, the person named Jesus Christ. He was a perfect, sinless Lamb of God, never sinned once, fully God and fully man, suffered and died on a rugged Roman cross, that blood-stained cross. What He was doing was paying the fine, because you broke the law. It's just that easy. We've all lied. We've all stolen. We've all looked at God. We've all hated somebody in our heart and have a good time in that. We've all done these things. We're going to be guilty of this. He will judge us. We will be guilty. But the Lord your God has made a way out through Christ. So hung on that cross. That blood-stained cross. So I say to you today, you must repent of your sin. Put your faith in Jesus Christ, like you put your faith in a parachute. You don't put a parachute on an airplane to enhance your flight. Why would you put Christ on to enhance your flight? You put the parachute on to save you from the jump to come,